Will ever know what is in the heart of a dog. This is the story of a great love. The love of a dog for one man. A love that was to prove even stronger than life itself.
Shep. No, no, go dig, 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 keep digging. That $1 million dish, we've hit it this time, Shep. We've hit it sure. No, keep going. I forgot to peer the shaft up. Come darn near being the richest corpse in the territory. Come on, girl. We're heading for town. Just wait till you see Frank Blake's eyes when we tell him he's a millionaire.
Well, Jonathan, how are you? Merry Christmas. How about it, on the house?
No.
Well, how about you, Pup? Pup? Can't call you Pup anymore, can I, fella?
Can't call her a fella, neither.
Say, that's right. Excuse me, beautiful. Well, how's it going, Jonathan?
Shep and me ain't complaining. Steve, has Frank been around tonight?
Frank? Frank Blake? Be right back.
Thanks, Steve. Hear me out. Jonathan Harvey? That's right.
I'm Lynn Taylor. Sorry we couldn't let you know, Jonathan. Martha wanted to, but there was no way of finding you in time.
Time for what?
Frank's death, Jonathan. Over a month ago in the morning.
Tommy worries me, Jonathan. Do you know that he's never once cried? If he could just let it out.
We'll work it out, Martha. We'll find a way. But right now, what about this fella Taylor?
Lynn's a fine man. He's been wonderful.
Why did Frank take him in as a partner?
He had to. Lynn's buying in when he did kept us from losing everything.
I see. Does that make him a partner of grubstake right?
Yes, why? Jonathan, you've made a strike.
I got something to show you.
Lynn.
Hello, Martha.
Come in. Jonathan's inside. I'm so glad you're here. Jonathan has something to show us.
Yeah. Look at this. I found a vein of that. If it's deep enough, it could be the biggest strike this territory has ever seen. That's why we've got to file a claim, and quick.
File before it's proved? If you file now and word gets out that you struck ore like this, every claim jumper in the territory will be in those hills in a week. Before you're sure yourself that you've hit the main vein.
By gad, you're right. 30 years of mud scrabbling, and when I do find the glory dust, I go off half-cocked. Mr. Taylor, Martha's right about you. And right now, you can start working at being a partner by lining me up some supplies.
Of course, Jonathan, anything you need.
I'll meet you in the store in a half hour.
All right. Good night, Martha.
Good night, Lynn.
If it's all right with you, Martha, I'd like to talk a mite with Tommy.
All right, Jonathan. If there's anything you can do.
Got his way of doing things we just can't answer.
I didn't want to cry.
You go ahead and cry. Used to do it myself sometimes, before my tears all dried up on me. Now, how about Shep here? Those hills up there, that's no place for a dog. Leastwise, not Shep.
It isn't?
No, not too lonesome. She likes folks around. Fact is, she just plain ain't happy up there. As for me, well, I'm better off alone. Lots of times, the dog is nothing but a darn bother to me.
A bother to you? Shep?
Now, what ails you, Shep? Now, come on. Go on out here. You get away. Now, come on. Get away. Now, what I'm sandwashing up to with all this is, how about taking her off my hands? Will you do it, Tom? Will you?
You're no liar, Jonathan. I can't take Shep from you. He's your dog. Nobody else's till she dies. Thanks anyway. And look, don't tell anybody I bawled. Will you please?
Honest to Christmas. We didn't do so good. All right, it's Christmas. And giving is part of Christmas. Anyway, you are a father to me. I'll be quiet. And don't look at me that way.
Christmas, Ma.
Look. Yes, dear, I know.
Dear Tommy, I put it up to Shep. She agreed with me. She's yours. Merry Christmas from Jonathan. Where is Jonathan?
He's gone.
Gone? Is it all right, Ma? Can I really keep her?
That's what he wanted, Tommy. I'm sure.
with her, Mr. Bald Eagle? What's wrong?
Kamukshwik sick. Lili yaka helu nanas yaka tayi.
He say dog Shep not eat because she want to go home.
To Jonathan?
Ayazulu. Nimlus was yaka helu nanit Jonathan.
He say dog starve till die if not go Jonathan.
Thanks, Mr. Bald Eagle. Thanks. Masi. Goodbye, Red Wing.
Bahayat.
Ma, we've got to get her to Jonathan. Please, Sarang, take her. Please, Ma.
Well, I don't know, dear. How could you ever find him?
Shep could. She knows where the claim is.
But you still couldn't go alone.
I'll take him, Martha. Be glad to.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Taylor. You hear that, Shep? We're going to take you back to Jonathan. Now you've got to eat and get strong for the trip. Here, take some. You've got to.
Thanks, Ed.
Ma, look! She's eating. She's going to be all right. Chef, where is he? Jonathan? Jonathan?
Here, Tommy.
Jonathan, what's wrong?
Fever. Hit me a week ago. The worst is past. So weak, I couldn't get food any longer.
That's what was wrong with Shep. She knew. She wouldn't eat. She made us bring her here. Ma's right, Jonathan. Shep's your dog, and nobody else's. So I'm giving her back to you. Right now.
Never mind the dog, Tommy. Tommy, you rustle up some wood. I'll see about the food.
I'm all right, girl. And thanks.
Taylor, I guess you'll wonder how our partnership's been going. You were right. I'd have been a fool to file that claim. Vane petered out in a week. So I just kept working upstream, surface stuff. Hardly worth a man's time. I'll show you. Tommy, go on over there by the shell. Now slide that chest out. The board underneath will lift up. Take them out. Look inside, Tommy.
How much is here, Jonathan?
Oh, not much. Only around about
$6,000. $6,000?
And plenty more to come.
$6,000? You say that's just from gravel? You still haven't found the main vein?
No, but it's up there. I aim to just work upstream until I find it. And I will, as sure as your name's Lynn Taylor.
Jonathan, do you realize what this means?
It means we're rich.
All of us. Sure we are, but that's not what I'm talking about. You need help. Now look, I'm starting back to town tomorrow. I'll take this gold and deposit it in all our names. It'll be safe there. And I'll be back. Why, with proper equipment, we can take that gold out 10 times as fast.
All my life, I've waited for something like this. And I'm not taking any chance on losing it now.
Run the inlet channel across there and build a sluice box below the rapid. Let her go, Tommy. When do you see one day's take from this baby, Taylor? Just wait.
I tell you, I heard somebody. Somebody's out there.
Sure, the same fellas you've been hearing for 3 days.
You said yourself there are other prospectors over in Oak Valley. What if they got word somehow that we've hit it?
Sure. A little bird flew down and told them. So they came running right back here so they could dig up all our pretty gold right in the driving rain.
You may think it's funny, but I don't. And from now on, we're keeping a guard here at the cabin while we're up at the mine. We got to.
All right, Taylor. Then you stand guard. Tommy and me will work the mine. Or maybe that'd worry you, too. You'd be wondering if we were losing some of it before we got here. Now ease up, Taylor. Stop worrying. The richest dust in creation is no blame good if you kill yourself getting it. Now go on and get some sleep. I'm going to.
Button that saddlebag. For days you've been watching us, but you didn't fool me. I knew you were out there.
You heard what I said. Move!
Go on. Go get what you put in there.
Taylor, what's going on here?
You keep out of this, Jonathan. I know what I'm doing. Well, do you get it or don't you?
You crazy fool. I ought to lay you low.
Make him show you what he put in that saddlebag.
I took something from there. For this house.
He's lying. Look for yourself.
No, Taylor. You look.
But he was inside searching around, snooping.
For food. I would have prepared the table in the presence of my friends.
This is Pilot Pete, Taylor. You've been longer in these hills, you'd never have made that mistake. Don't make it again. Come on, Pete. Let's see about that supper.
You a regular person, Mr. Pete?
Regular? No, son. Reckon I'm as irregular as it comes. Got to have roots to be a regular parson. Me, I ain't got the roots of a tumbleweed. Two things I love above all else. The Lord's mountains and the Lord's sinners. So I spend my time in one looking for the other. And I sure find them. Here, lady.
You better leave Shep alone. She never makes up to strangers.
She don't? Here, lady. Well, you got it wrong, Brother Taylor. Thou sawest the beast that was and is not. Revelation 17:8. Why, there's plenty of love in this dog for them that loves her. Ain't the Shep. Or maybe she just likes my stew.
Pete, this is from all of us.
Well, in his name, I thank you, Jonathan.
Tommy,
Mr. Taylor, and you too, Lady Fair. The Lord be with you in all your labors. Lay not up for yourselves treasures on earth, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven. Matthew 6:19. Get up, Gabriel.
Bye, Mr. P.
Goodbye, Pete.
Goodbye.
Work, for the night is coming. Work through the morning hours. Work while the dew is sparkling.
Tommy, you go down to work. I'll be along.
Well, you gave him dust. That's a dust giveaway. We struck pay dirt. The old fool talks.
He won't. Pete knows the law of these hills, too. And he lives by it. You could try doing the same. And until you do, I'm taking that gun.
I keep my own gun.
You're edgy, dear. You're getting worse every time more gold goes under that floor. It ain't just being scared someone will steal it, neither. It's having to split it with Martha and me.
You're crazy.
Only a quarter, you keep thinking to yourself. I only get a quarter of it. And Jonathan gets half. That keeps eating at you, Taylor. I've been watching you and I know. That's why I'm taking that gun. No, you won't do that. There's two reasons why you won't shoot me, Taylor. The first, you won't find that vein without me. And the other is just a hunch that you haven't got the guts.
Good girl. Even your mom. Promise? Now, come on. Hi, Taylor. Hurry up. Tell your mom not to worry.
I will. Bye, Jonathan.
Shep? Where are you? Shep, what is this? What ails you? You know, between us, we gotta take care of that boy. He don't know these trails like we do.
Oh,
it ain't for good this time. You're coming back. Now go on, get. Jonathan!
Where are they going?
I sent Tommy home. The kid's getting lonesome for his mom. What's all the excitement?
Jonathan, that thing we've been looking for, if it was up there, what would it look like?
Well,
No, I'll tell you. The sheer face of the cliff. White quartz, the whitest you ever saw. And in it, jagged like lightning, a vein of pure gold. Gold, Jonathan, that wide. It's up there. So help me, I found it. It's up there waiting for us.
Where?
At the head of the canyon, way up.
Well, let's go.
About the mountain goats. Just beyond.
Let's go.
It's down on the ledge. What's the matter with you?
Shep. Where have you been all day? Looking for Jonathan? I'm afraid he won't be back, Shep. That doesn't mean you and I can't be friends. How about it?
Better be my way, Shep. I'd rather not have anything happen to you. Might make things harder for me to explain.
Get away, I tell you! I said get away from there. Get away and you get what he got. Hungry enough yet, huh? You will be. Is what you want? That's the way it is, huh? Here. Ah. Now get out of here. Get out. And remember, you asked for it.
Eagle in town. Find quick. Maybe he saved dog.
Thank you. bashosh tai. Go bashosh ilhe.
Please, Mr. Bald Eagle, isn't there anything else you can do?
You take her your house. Be soon well.
Don't you worry, Shep. I'm gonna find out about that poison. Nothing's gonna stop me till I do.
Storm could start a slide that would cover the gold forever.
Tommy, what are you doing here?
Where's Jonathan?
He's gone. He's been gone for 3 days.
Where?
I don't know. Over towards Blue Mountain somewhere. He thought he might pick us up a deer for meat through the winter.
I heard his whistle.
You couldn't have.
Shep must have, too. She was barking.
When did you see Shep?
The Indian kids found her. She was almost dead. From poison.
But she's all right now?
Yeah, but I knew Jonathan would want to know, so I brought her back. Mr. Taylor, are you sure he's not here? I know I heard.
I told you, Tommy's not here.
Shep! 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 Here, Shep! Why don't she come in? I know she's out there.
Don't worry about it, Tommy. You're tired and upset. Good night's sleep, and you start home in the morning. Sit down now and rest. I'll get you some supper.
I'd better unsaddle my horse, Mr. Taylor. I'll be right back.
All right, then.
Shep, what is it? What is it, Shep? Jonathan.
Tommy, is that you? Anybody that?
Shep!
Shut up, you!
Help, Shep!
I said shut up!
Come on, Lassie! Stop it!
Tommy, come on now. Drink it. You're all right now. Here. Drink, Tommy. Drink it. That's right. That's fine, boy.
Get away from me! Leave me alone!
Listen, son, you've got to listen to me. There's nothing to be afraid of. You're here, perfectly safe, and I brought you here. Now listen. You've been scared, Tommy. I know that, and it's my fault. But that's because I was scared too. So scared that I almost lost my head. A man can be scared too, Tommy. Even of a kid like you. Especially if that kid gets the wrong idea in his head. And you've got the wrong idea, son.
You lied. You said he was hunting.
Yes. Yes, I lied. You know why? Because I knew you loved Jonathan, Tommy. Almost as much as your own father. So I didn't know how to tell you just like that. Jonathan is dead, son. He was working up in the canyon and he fell. It was an accident. 2 days ago, I found his body and, well, I buried it where you saw. I was coming in tomorrow to tell you more.
Shep. Where's Shep?
Shep's all right. I saw her outside a while ago. Shep was like you, son. She got the wrong idea, too. So, let's both of us forget about what happened tonight, shall we?
I guess so.
Sure we will. Now you get some sleep, and you'll be fine in the morning. Just sleep, son, and forget the whole thing. To Jonathan. Better let me do all the explaining. All right?
Hey, Jonathan! Hi, Mr. Taylor. Mel Steiner and Carl Crane. This runaway come into their camp over in Oak Flats last night, and I thought I remembered he was yours. They was breaking camp for winter anyway, so on the way into town, figured we'd cut across the ridge and fetch him back. Why, hello there, Tommy boy.
Hi, Mr. Pete. Gee, I'm sure glad to see you.
We both are, Pete. Mighty glad. And thanks for bringing the horse back.
Sure. Where's Jonathan?
It's a good thing you men came along. Come inside. I'm afraid I got some bad news for you.
And in thy heavenly kingdom, Lord, let him find peace. That peace which passeth understanding. Let the gold he sought on earth be his in heaven, the pure and shining gold of thy holy grace. We ask it, Lord, in his name. Amen. Come along.
Explain everything in town.
That I will.
As long as you can take Tommy and the dog back for me, I'll probably stay on up here till spring. For everyone's sake, I'd like to prove Jonathan was right. You see, he was sure there was real pay dirt here. So far, we've never found it. And Pete, do all you can to help Tommy, will you? You know, kids sometimes imagine all sorts of things, and Jonathan's accident hit the boy pretty hard. I'm sure you understand.
I do indeed, Mr. Taylor.
Pete, he's lying. Don't believe him. Please don't believe him. It wasn't an accident. Jonathan didn't fall. He killed him. I know he did. Pete, he's lying. He's lying about everything.
Tommy.
voice is terrible.
He hated Jonathan and he killed him. And last night when I found out, he tried to kill me too. He's lying, Pete.
Tommy, listen to me. You say I wanted to kill you? Where did you sleep last night? Who picked you up when your horse threw you and carried you to the cabin? Well, Tommy, you slept 6 feet from me the whole night through, safe and well. Does that sound like I wanted to hurt you? Answer me.
Pete, don't believe him. He did do it. Shep knows too. That's why I tried to poison her. You don't believe me. He said the claim didn't pay out, but it did. There's bags full of gold in that cabin, a dozen of them.
If that's true, guess you can show us some.
I will. Come on.
There was more. A lot more. He's done something with the rest.
You better take these back to Martha. I was holding this hoping that I'd have a bigger haul by spring.
There is more now. A lot more. Mr. Crane, can't you see he's lying? Mr. Steiner, don't believe him. Please don't believe him.
Guess we'd better be going.
Please, Mr. Pete.
Come on, son.
Thank you.
We'll keep trying, son.
Sure it is.